You need to actually play this game. You need to actually play all the Zelda games. Why am I playing this? You get down here and play this.
That's true, I guess. You've played Majora and Ocarina.
I think you got through Wind Waker and Twilight Princess. Oh, it's on B. That's fine for this. I should have looked up what the timing rules for this game are. I'm pretty sure though, just go forward and beat the game is gonna be good enough. I know I can't go out of bounds for the normal category. Taking all the damage here. Shouldn't the game be beeping? We did it. Decide this is gonna be the hundo or not. I already got a piece of a heart though, so I guess that kind of decides it. I seem to remember things like get the mushroom. Please turn. Intended percent. In all seriousness, I think it's incredibly lame that they took the magic powder off the Tendi game in the Switch remake. It's like, oh no, we forgot that might mean people won't have to do our ridiculous side quest. Quick, patch it. I'm already good on hearts, okay. Oh, you know what? It's probably because... I don't know how long that lasts, and honestly, I just don't like the music. I'm playing on Game Boy interface, but I'm also using Red retro whatever's SNES controller to GameCube adapter, which introduces just enough input lag to make me angry. Take care, there's not much there. I'm trying to remember what the goal was for Tiny 10 number 1. It might have been clear the first dungeon. It might have just been get the key. Playing Link's Adventure a couple of days ago, I also said something along the lines of, shouts to Zelda 2 for actually being the first game where Link's shield is effective against swords and stuff. It's actually, I forgot about this game entirely. Games totally count. This is CDI games that don't count. Get my shovel money. There it is. I wasn't supposed to do that, just dock me 10 seconds. This is the compass! I can see where the chest and the nightmare are. It has a new feature! Honestly, having the compass tell you the key was in the room was the best feature they ever gave to it. Because it's true, it was basically a useless item. Because you're always like, let's go to the back, especially once they got rid of dungeons as a maze. I could go get the map. And then we can, say at last. Problem is, I forgot this NES controller has a flaky start button. It's not flaky, I guess, so much as I have to be very deliberate about pushing it. I still hate the music. Boss key. Got him.
Swamp. A path opens in the blooms.
I still really appreciate that the Switch version basically didn't change the dialogue at all. Like, the things that were different were 99% controller display, but, like, when it told you what button to push to do a thing. So it was, like, control related. And then the Yoshi line. Oh no! Something's going down at Nakatomi Plaza. Oh no. Not again. Lunker. First, I guess. I am desperately trying to remember if I actually need bombs for the next ending. I swear that's actually usually the fourth one I get. So where's the other one I didn't get? get him. You came here to get me, but it is I who will get you. There's any bomb walls in the second dungeon, so I can just do this. Best chain jump. What's up, great one, Bobo? Where's the chain jump I didn't? Where's the piece of heart I didn't get? That's really bugging me. Maybe I'm wrong and there just isn't one yet. This is the 20 spot. Joy! I didn't want that either. I have to listen to this dumb music forever. Good job, Bow Wow. I'm not supposed to go this way at all. Because this is not useful. Now I'm down a key. This isn't even really a speedrun, though. This is messing around. Thank you. Whoa! The next best thing the Switch version did was the quality of life upgrades, where the power bracelet, the boots, and the shield were always on. That's why I leave that Switch set that other way. Yeah, they basically didn't touch the game. They changed controller displays, and they updated the line about Yoshi starting to appear in a lot of games, too. He really has been in a lot of games now. I'll take that. About right. I thought I had myself soft-locked in Turtle Rock. I think in retrospect there's a bomb wall I didn't know about. And I just wasn't gonna play find the bomb hole. Although to this day I don't know where that bomb hole like, actually is, and I just would just assume not do anything close to it. Alright, we can do this. What's up, Conster? I don't know if that's proper technique, but it felt cool. This one I need bombs for anyway. I need a dash jump for this to work. This is just a bad place now. Mm-hmm. There's my shovel money and my bomb money. Make sure I tag that screen. Actually, that was the thing they did wrong with the remake. They nerfed the boomerang horribly. I'm just gonna walk over here with this. Yeah. You know. I was gonna say, did I just lose my ability to get out of there? Dun 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 dun. Bow Wow. I have to actually talk to you. Okay. Also making this game impossible in the remake was bad. Recently, he appeared starting to appear in a lot of games. Let's not go in there. Let's just not worry about it. I actually do need the stick now that I think about it. Well, not the stick, but I need the bananas. So I actually am gonna go to the beach. I was thinking, like, when do I want to go to the beach? It feels early to go to the beach. No, this is actually the appropriate time to go to the beach. He needs the meat. Crocodile will smile. What's the next thing I need cash for? I always forget. I know there is cash here. Richard's castle, I guess. They look a lot less like banana trees and more like trees that have teeth. I'm just throwing that out there. Like, go ahead, like, go back, what is it, 30 seconds, not even in the video, and look at the banana trees. They look like trees with giant killer teeth that are out to kill you. Just saying. I'm not sure if anybody else ever had that sensation about those trees. That's what I need to buy, a potion. Mm-hmm. And that's the other piece of a heart I can get now. Thanks, Pro Infernape. Actually, I need the bracelet right here, don't I? Yeah, because otherwise, you would never wait to get this. Stop, Crazy Tracy. I hope the bitrate isn't like that dead. Nice! I need this to get out of here. Definitely not it. Did I just like... No, there it is. Piece of a heart cave. Whoa! Five or not. Ow. Mm-hmm. It is totally casual percent. What's up, Blue Bomber? It does say casual up there. Nice. Oh my god. Did that actually just happen? The Book of Dad Jokes. What's the next dad joke in here? What under the sea creature works out at the gym? Muscles. Thank you, Pro Infernate, for redeeming that dad joke. I should put this book on the bottom of the page in the Amazon list. Got it. See it as like they noticed that, especially the one that just dies in the hole would probably leave that leaf somewhere in a really weird spot, and the way to avoid that was to just have it jump to you, although they could have avoided it even more by just having the heart spawn in the middle of the room like they did with Turtle Rock way back when. Like this one just sits there. Mr. Kev, 55 bombs. An explosive viewer. An explosive Twitch experience. I guess I don't have any other way off of here. I need to still put up the rewards for figuring out how to do board games online and switching hats. Those are the other things I need to put up some ridiculous point awards for. Talk to him and say yes. Is this money or a seashell? I think this is money. No, it's another blob. It's a seashell. Am I up to 7? Remember, folks, the other way to get a dad joke is to claim that resub. There we go. The one thing about playing this with, like, the glitchless sort of rule set... Although, I think this one you can actually, like, do some weirdness walking up along the side of it. But, whatever. I'm gonna actually at least get in a position. Level 2 sword before level 4? You can actually do that? I don't know about before level 4, but, I think usually 6 is around the time I actually end up getting it. Very possible. I'm up to 8. 9. Well, we'll see what's around. But I know there's at least a couple near the shoreline I haven't gotten yet. That was a key. I'm glad I got it. One more. Get wrecked. There we go. I wasn't sure if that room had one or not. This room does. Got the dash boots. Run jumps are now a thing. I said, run jumps are now a thing. Hey, we run jump. Literally free. We got the compass! It has a new feature. Like, by putting the chests and, and keys and the keytone and everything else, the compass instantly became, like, the first item you got in the dungeon over the map. Is that two keys? I like that they put the key at the entrance here. So now instead of the dungeon music, we the next like half hour. That was weird. That's four and the boss key, so let's go. Haven't seen that before. Yeah, weird plant. This dungeon with the extra key because you may have locked yourself out of some rooms. I guess we just proved that you can do extra damage with the sword spin. Ba 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 ba. Thank you. time. This is cash. This is really the only time you're able to get this. I mean, you can come back for it, but... Memory serves, this is a stupid cave. That's like the hardest piece of a heart to find in the game. Not because it's especially hard to get to, it's just, why would you ever look there? Might not be the hardest because the one in the water outside the castle is another weird one. I didn't want to knock you with a stick, I just wanted to skip your dialogue. Honey. Big hair fairy. and seashells. Alright, so I get one by going to the shrine right now. I get two by going to, there's one in the desert, there's one if I go further south. There's one I can sort of, it's in the corner. There's one digging on top of the plateau. Like, the number of shells actually does start piling up. There's two in level one. It's actually scaring me how many there are hiding around. Let me get the thing where I need to... Let me trigger Marin so I can at least take one trip down there. I have to go up here now, don't I? There's actually nothing stopping me from getting the face key. Shoutouts to Game Boy interface, I guess. You need it, but we're getting it. Z1 Rando looks a lot different.
Fred! Why did you put an owl in the game?
I don't like that the relief is flickering up there, and I don't really want to save and quit, but I feel like I almost should. Welcome to hour two, I guess. What I'm looking for is that little potion that's next to the honeycomb. Trying to think where the next opportunity to actually pick up arrows is, and I've got nothing. Dang. We almost made it. Okay, yeah, it's here. I should've just dug for hearts. That would've been smart. And I can just go help. What a boost. Do I need to actually have the pineapple to get the bear to talk about getting Marin? That's a piece of the game I don't completely remember. Actually critical. Not critical, but it's, you know, you should really get the third warp point here. Thank you. Huh. That's 15, and I know where a couple more still are. Can I really get there? Before level 4 at least? Like, level 5 I think at this point is a cinch. But 4? 4 still feels questionable. I don't think I've dug here. Like, ever. Shout out to Die Hard. Oh, thief. I'm also glad they kept it, so it was worth it being the Switch game with no deaths. Whether or not you consider it worth it, they kept the Easter egg. Yeah. Lesson one, when your girlfriend asks if you're listening, you say yes. Is she still here? You got Marin! For some reason, I was told I could not, like, lift my wife over my head at the end of the wedding. You've never actually seen that? I mean, yeah, that's a part of this game. That was one of the ones I knew that still existed. There's one more on top of here. There's one in the desert, at least. I'm at 16. Very obvious out of bounds segment there. Yeah, this works. Down here, there should be nothing. I saw somebody tweeting about that on the Switch version. I forgot that was here in the Game Boy version. Marin yells at you for playing Zelda. Crow and Fernape, we're the last... I know I need three, and I know there's at least one in the desert. In, like, the bottom right corner. Where are the other ones? If I need only two more. Yeah, I need two more seashells. I need three more, but one of them I know is in the bottom right corner of the desert. That's fair. Lanmo went from boss to mini-boss. Went from dropping a heart container to a piece of a heart container. That's the one I knew about. I think I enjoy the Game Boy Learn a Song cutscenes a lot more than the 64 ones in Ocarina. Game Boy's cooler, what can I say? Sheik drops in and is like, play this melody on a harp. Impa's like... Link, like, literally, like, plays a little duet with Marin. Listens to frogs play, like, sing their hearts out. And similar things. Aw, Nice low games. Best music. Telltale Heights is like some of the best music in the series. There's a heart, piece of a heart to tease you the rest of the game, pretty much. It's one of the last ones you get. The last one you get is on Turtle Rock. It's just too easy to just keep coming in here. I'll definitely take that. I still need arrows, though. This is like the compass. Oh, it's a tablet piece. This is the map. This is the first map we're actually getting. At last! You got the map! Kind of works, actually. I honestly don't know how out of logic I am right now. I know I am out of logic. Because you're not supposed to make that jump. supposed to basically be trapped until you get... the flippers. Okay. I'm gonna do the trick where, I'm gonna do this. You basically don't ever finish level 4 until the end. Level 4 is the last thing you finish. And that way you never have to actually do the ghosts. Because the ghost stops you from doing a lot of things, but the ghost doesn't stop you from entering the windfish's egg. At least that's my understanding of it. And so with this, I have everything I actually need to finish this dungeon. Nah, that's fair. I mean, it's a thought. That gives me one more seashell. How do I get out of here? I mean, honestly, part of me is thinking, you know, if I just up an A, I don't have to find my way out of here. I guess I could just use the warp from our good friend, the Octorok. It's casual to a point, I guess. I'm gonna try it. Let's see. This way first. Oh, this is further away than I thought. Is it 12 pieces of heart in this game, or 16? I have 8 now. There's 5 more dungeon hearts. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, there's only 4 more. One's on Turtle Rock, one's on Death Mountain. One is outside Richard's castle. Where's the last one? It's behind the animal village. It's the hookshot one. Oh! This is my bad dancing. Best quality of life upgrade. Being able to use Mambo's Mambo as a general purpose warp. This time I'll try to not die. Two more seashell sighting. One of them is down the south coast. one of them's over here. All right, that's 20. Good, now I get to listen to this music for an hour. That's a seashell. I think it's a seashell. It's the rooster one. I have to go this way, right? By the time I'm done, this will qualify as a hundo run. At least a hundo playthrough. This game has two really mean pieces of a heart, and one of them is the one in that random cave by the honeycomb. This is the other one. Why would you ever look there? I need to get the, oh, that's how I'll get all my arrows back. I need to get the arrow capacity upgrade at some point anyway. That's 20. Hello? I want the different cursingest curse that was ever a curse. Thank you. Oh no. I am literally made of arrows now. My arrow count has now increased by 59. Max count has increased by 30, but yeah. Come on. How ominous. What training am I up to? the hibiscus. Could in theory go to the animal village. Send the letter. Get the broom. I can get the boomerang now. No, not Riley. Thank you for the raid. How's it going? I guess I will listen to your requests. Mr. Wright. Of all the ways for me to get close to Mr. Wright's house, this is probably the fastest one. That's who wrote it. You know, what's up, Mellowflows? We got the broom. We're just cleaning up the magnifying glass quest right now. It's the best way for me to get back to everything. It's actually probably to go here. I don't know which. I don't know where the cleaning lady is. I don't know what else to call her. Whoever it is who has the broom all the time. Sword blocked. She needs a broom. How much does it cost to get the Song of Life? Is it 300 or 500? Fishing hook, so I need to go to the fisherman. Oh. I need the hookshot to finish this up. Well, no biggie. I still need to swim out to the mermaid anyway. Compass has a new feature. I don't know my own jump height. Aww. Merry Cadmus, it's true. I was thinking earlier, do I want to go there and say Merry Cadmus? But now that somebody else has already done it for me, I mean, almost have to. I should almost get the acorn based on I have 5 hearts left. Now here's the real question. Is this the water temple, or is the one with the flippers the water temple? Because we all know the worst dungeon in every Zelda game is the water temple. Yo, cab thinking emoji might be my new favorite thing. Think they'd try to do it without that. I'm opening the chest. I don't know if I have to or not.
I've got what was inside this box. Come get it, Master Skull. Master Stalfos, whatever. I'm putting a skull.
Into the tower is the water temple. That's what got me about the remake. In the remake, that kill doesn't carry over long enough. I'm still trying to figure out what you mean by into the tower. Yo, what's up, Kalen? Oh, Eagle Tower is actually a pain. I have fond memories of getting like phone calls late at night about how do I get through Eagle Tower in like, what was it, like fourth or fifth grade when this game came out? I know it's seven. Once you say it is the Eagle Tower, it's like, I know what it is. Okay, Alemi, you would be the first. I actually typed in Link's Awakening, and my options were to have the Switch, like, little cover, or to say it was Link's Awakening DX, and this is not Link's Awakening DX. So, we had a conundrum. There's already a D-make. Baby cab presents. So we had one thing, because I'm terrible at wrapping presents. So I did order like some already wrapped. Turns out babies and the little bag from Amazon don't... He doesn't know what to do with the bag. Not that he would know what to do with the present anyway. But he got that. The big one has been assembled and is waiting now. Everybody just get your Switch version jokes out of your system now. Let's just do it. It's Christmas Eve. We're within an hour on the East Coast. And you have 365 days for me to forget before Festivus. Am I using Joy-Cons or the Pro Controller? I'm using a SNES to Switch adapter. Actually, that would be hilarious if I played... I actually did recently get a GameCube adapter for USB stuff. It would actually be impressive to see if the SNES to GameCube controller adapter worked with it. You're ecstatic! By the way, that was the first time in my life I ever saw the word ecstatic when I opened that chest the first time. This is... Baby gets one. You know, I learn more things just playing games than I think I ever did in school. Okay, that's probably not entirely true, but I do learn lots of things just from playing games and making jokes and then being told, no, I don't know things. Yeah... I don't have the boss key either, do I? I got ahead of myself. Let's not do that. Well, I remember where the keys are in this dungeon. It's like the new vocabulary words. I get it now. They want me to do this. I'm like fighting through the traps. It's like, no, the game actually expects you to do this. It was actually at a Pathfinder game, so a tabletop D20 game. And they started talking about a foundry. I was like, what the hell is a foundry? All I know is that that there's a thing in Halo that talks about the foundry. But I don't know what one is. I still barely know what one is. I believe it's where you make stuff. Ooh, the save. You can, like, try and teach people stuff all day in school, and they'll never learn anything. It's not that they won't learn anything. You know what I mean. You have to have people do stuff they like, and then they're paying attention. Plus, you hit on, like, weird things that random stuff won't normally include. And then you have a laugh as your vocabulary gets bigger, because you misuse words. Yeah, it's like, what the hell's a foundry? Foundry's a map. I mean, I know foundry is not... They named it foundry for a reason, but I don't know what it means. Get wrecked. Ruin my runs in the third hand, will you? Gone. As much as I hate the music, it's really nice to have for a boss fight. A foundry is like a place where you make big things. That's my understanding of it now. Sense for what I know. Ah! Ow. I hate this boss, by the way. Like, I get the concept, but that tail is just too strong of a defense. I mean, yeah, it basically boils down to you're gonna make big metal things. These last two splits have been, like, really long. But, I got a lot of things on the side taken care of. Next thing I'm getting is the boomerang. And then I already have the face key. Is there anything closer I can use to climb up? Thank you. Nothing here after all. Main reason to get the boomerang early is I'm pretty sure it can kill Wizrobes. In this version of the game, the boomerang is OP. It's my least favorite nerf in the Switch version. Game. Okay, game, we'll do it your way. Shouts to bomb arrows. I've heard legends that this jump can be made. Yep, that's all of them. Because I have the one in the random Death Mountain cave and then the one on Turtle Rock. Which screen is this? All hail! I think I can just go all the way there. You already talked to me at the one where I came out, at that time I came out of the one to the south. Thank you. Eastern Palace and the Face Shrine both look like it's the New York Public Library. I thought it outright killed him. I do go this way first. I don't know what's up with the spots. This room is like pitch black normally. Oh, good. Power bracelet 2. Pretty sure there's nothing of value this way. It's like the stone tablet or something. Oh wow, it's not even the chest with the stone tablet, it's the tablet that I need the stone tablet for. That's gonna be the big problem with this. I don't remember, like, what the sequence of times I need to hit the crystal switch is. And the last key you need to get is, like, really out of the way. Come on. Need a key. Secret is in the eyes. Sure. This actually is where I need to go up to get to the boss game, isn't it? I still have a key. Oh no, that was my key. That is the key that I have. I still don't understand those heads at all. Like, I know that they're little chest knights and you need them both to land up, but I don't get how they function. And I know it's, like, written somewhere, but... Take that extra bomb, thank you.
How ominous.
Link is 1-for-1 on face-offs in this run. Completely change this screen because they realized you didn't actually need boots to make it. I appreciate this puzzle. Your reward is this way. All the way from Subcon, although this is a dream, isn't it? This will be a good bathroom break, I guess. It's 300, not 5. Good. I hope everybody enjoyed the Song of Life there. I'm gonna slowly back away, apparently. Dang, we missed the split. This is the last time I'm coming here. I'm vaguely aware that there's supposed to be a set route, but for the sake of argument and for the sake of a truly casualish, nice easy pattern.
Mm-hmm.
Hero is trying to confuse me. Joke's on you, there are no downs. Now he's giving me his energy, that works. Modify emote. Mr. Cat with sunglasses is actually kind of cool. Even if I'm not playing Mega Man X8 right now. That doesn't help me. I need this. There we go. Oh boy, pyramids. Save the menu. Barbecue. Watching too much PJ. Excellent. I don't think there's anything of value this way, but I totally forget when and where I get that piece of a heart. I'm pretty sure it's not here. This is the chest cave? Yeah. They all have 20s. This is the seashell, and I have the sword, so it's a 20. I'm told it's the most common drop in the game. And by the game, I mean what's the best. I'm pretty sure wherever the entrance is to get that, it's on the other side, so... Middle-ish of the screen is where the drop is. I don't want the drop. What?
maddening.
Take that, puzzle. Okay, I mean, that sort of works. Damn it, Kirby. This is the tile room. So this is the next thing that the remake got rid of. Nice.
Thank you.
I don't think I need to specifically do it like this. I'm just used to doing it like this. That's also a seashell, except now it's 20. I just also don't remember how to get it at all. I like that that guy got upgraded from a random Dark World enemy to actual mid-boss. That's where it needs to be. I'll take the heart. I didn't get them all in one pass. Wow, those dives. This is the dungeon where it starts getting weird because there's Goombas just wandering around. The intro music, the Mario stop sound. Nice. Mm-hmm. please. Don't go down the central one. Don't ever go down that one. Unless you want to go down the mountain for some reason. How do you get up here, Taryn? Hundo piece. dungeon enemies on Death Mountain. Hypothetically need the mirror shield for. Well, I'm pretty sure the powers that be have figured out how to get around it. Is, but I really like it. Ow. T-Rock. Is this the map? At last. Nice. Where's this go? Was this my actual path to get to Mike Tyson's punch out? What a video game. Thank you. there's a lot of remembering the principles to these places and not actually remembering how it truly works. And that's that room. The compass. I mean, you know, it's new to this dungeon, right? This compass comes with a new feature, so are you back again, too? Get wrecked. Dungeon's problem. Every time you have to get back somewhere if you're not gonna save and quit. Ooh. Fast. Thank you. these guys just respawn. Let's go down to the rope room. Yeah. Now what I think happens from here is I get through a bomb room here. Kill a mini boss. And then I have to go back and get the crystal switch. Yep, because they're the blocks and they're up. Okay, good. Some extra bad things can happen in that fight. That's what I kept forgetting to do here. path either. We're just here to kill Pushy again. First thing I need to do is get to... This isn't it either, though. I guess I have to make a hard right. Eventually get me there. Because the other things I need are right by the entrance. How are my arrows looking? Because I will need those. I should remember that they just have this here. He just regenerated too. Merry Christmas, everybody. What are we looking at? 330? I swear, every time there's one of these puzzles in a video game, the reason I can solve it is this game. He exploded again. It was a terrible tragedy. I think I actually want to go this way. What's that staircase? Hearts are looking good. Mistake was going against some was getting into a mashing war with somebody who plays Mega Man games. That's why I was afraid of Duckfist playing Mario 3. It seemed like a recipe for fire kills. Split after 7 either. That is the way off here, isn't it? That happened. It might be less than 3:30. It shouldn't take too long to take out the anglerfish. That's right, we did this. My favorite thing about this dungeon. I feel like bomb arrows would have had him dead by now. Look at that split. You already went to the bay. Part of me thinks the move is actually to... Actually, yeah, I think it is. The move was to just use the ocarina. I said the ghost never even showed up. I'm pretty sure we're officially Hundo. We have all the instruments, we have all the items, we have all the upgrade items, we have the 3 upgrades, we have 14 hearts. Where we ask for get S's on blue balls, I guess. Pro Infernip says 1. Oh, there it is. Look at this time loss. 5. Oh,
5.
Big guy.
Hi-ya!
My least favorite thing they got rid of in the remake. That doesn't work anymore. So two more cycles? Still two more cycles, because I can miss one shot in here. Actually, if it's 14, I only need two more. Auglib. Auglib, how did your playthrough of Pear and the Witch's Curse, Grey Witch, go? Never give up. You gave up? You couldn't get, like, the 100 apples on top of the mountain with the Auglib strats? Not the Auglib, the Author Blue strats. Auglib, thank you for hosting my Link to the Past Hundo PB. I say that because I don't think I've actually sat and timed it before. I must have done this in one sitting before, but... Leaderboard has lots of glitches that I don't know about for dupes, so this is 6th out of 6 times. I don't know what a warp is, but I'm pretty sure I didn't do a warp, so this does actually... is not last on any percent warpless. So we've got that. Yeah, we could have cut the 315 if we didn't get any blue balls. Instead, we got 5 blue balls. You know, Seabass with the 122. We're nowhere near that one. This was also deathless and no save and quit. For whatever that's worth. No, thanks, Ariel. It is a run for the no save and quit category that does not appear to exist. I mean, I think this technically qualifies for every category. I don't think... Well, actually, it might be no save and quit world record, but at the same time... You would have to say no save and quit and no major glitches, because I'm pretty sure there is a way to beat the game going horribly out of bounds that doesn't save and quit. So that would technically be your no save and quit. Yeah, this is original. The wails of attachment. I just now figured out why Auglib posted the wail earlier. I got there. I didn't need help. I think we are required under speedrunning law to watch the credits, though. And then, as much as I don't want to waste the Auglib host here, there's a small human who's gonna, like, be trying to wake up. Why are the credits so messed up right now? Oh, you know what it is? It's because I'm on a flat screen TV, a flat screen CRT, and I can tell on the stream it looks a lot clearer than it does over here. Yeah, small human's gonna wake up tomorrow and discover stuff. And I'm still new enough at the whole thing, even though he's been, you know, waking me up and keeping me exhausted for the past I don't know how many months now. I actually do know how many months, I'm just not saying it on stream. This is like Halloween. Your sacred duty is to give kids candy when they come knocking on your door. Christmas morning, your sacred duty is to give the kid a bunch of toys. We're going to Bobby. Is Bobby still playing Mega Man 9? Tell me he's still playing Mega Man 9. Just stopped. We're going to Rick. Or did Rick just stop? Did everybody I was about to host just stop? JSR. Man, I missed Marin.